Let's talk about recommendation systems. So, recommendation system, basically the goal here is to offer suggestions to the user, right? That's the basic goal. Now, they differ in terms of the approach companies take to offer those recommendations, right? So, an example of these recommendations are, so let's see, if you go to bing.com, for example. So bing.com is a very popular search engine, right? And if you look at the trending articles here, like this talks about the popular news items which are trending at this point. So these are kind of suggestions. Another example is if you go to walmart.com, which is an e-commerce online search engine. So here, when a customer is buying a product, they can also suggest like what other customers bought when they bought this product, right? So the goal here is to try to upsell or cross-sell a set of similar products, right? Because if you take a look at any e-commerce company like Amazon, Walmart, Google, Microsoft, they have billions and billions of products, right? So they always are in trying to find out the avenues by which they can surface more and more products to the user. So recommendation offers a natural way where, as the user is browsing the products or they are purchasing the product, at various points they can start offering the suggestions, right? So that's basically recommendation systems a lot about. So there are several types of recommendation system. Basically they differ in the way we offer the recommendations. So we have item-based collaborative filtering, then content-based recommendations, user-based collaborative filtering, personalized. So those are the four types. Now there are some fancy terms here which talks about collaborative filtering. So collaborative filtering is nothing but crowdsourcing, right? So where, let's say in case of item based, if I'm trying to purchase an item, collaborative filtering tries to find out what are the similar items which are liked by other users, and it computes recommendation based on that. In case of user based collaborative filtering, it computes, it tries to cluster the user based on their age, gender, what they have liked, and then if a new user comes in and who has similar habits of other users, he will be recommended same products that users similar to him have been using. Content based is purely based on the content and has nothing to do with how users have rated the system. And personalized, based on my personal habits, the system will offer me recommendations. So we will look at example of each one of these in following few minutes. So let's talk about content-based recommendations. So in case of content-based, the recommendations are offered purely based on the content. The content could be news or a product, and the characteristics could be the popularity of the content, like how popular is the content, or it could be trending content, right? If the content is the, if a, like a movie is becoming very popular, it will start becoming viral and people can just offer suggestions on that. So let's say a few examples of content based system. So if you go to the Bing, let's go back to our Bing example. Let's go to the home page. So this is an example. This news articles which are appearing over here, these are examples of content based recommendations. So here these news articles are trending, like American Airlines passenger was charged or like news about the American politics. These are the articles which are trending, like lot and lot of people are reading it at this time. So it's because of the content, purely content, right? Content of that article. And depending on the popularity, they try to surface at the top. There will be millions of such articles, but they are sorted based on the popularity. So most popular items will surface at the top. So this is a content-based recommendation system where purely based on the content, then their popularity, those articles will be suggested. So the next one is collaborative filtering, which we saw two types here, item-based and user-based. So collaborative filtering, as I said, is a fancy name. So basically, all it does is it uses the crowdsourcing. So let me give you an example of an item-based collaborative filtering. The best way to go here is to take an example of Amazon.com site. So let's say here is an example of an Apple Watch that I'm trying to purchase. And here you will see these are the recommendations that Amazon is offering. And these are based on the item similarity that I'm trying to buy an iWatch. So when other users also try to buy the iWatch, it tries to crowdsource what are the most type of products they were looking at, right? So here are like the different variation of Apple Watch that the users were also looking when they were looking at these items. So right, so this is finding the relationship between this item and the other items based on how other users have rated this item. So this is an example of an item based similarity. Now in case of the other type we saw was the user based collaborative filtering. Here in case of user based collaborative filtering, the suggestions are based on clustering the users, right? So here basically Amazon mainly uses the item based. So I don't have a good example of user based collaborative filtering, but I can just talk through it. So here is an example of a user based collaborative filtering. So we have basically it's a loan approval system where you have already fed in the information about the users, like their name, age, gender, income, and the system will output whether the loan can be approved or not. Let's say the loan amount is about $5,000. So first of all, system learns from this user's information that under what conditions the loan is approved historically. It tries to cluster those users into a bucket, right? So maybe the age group between 30 to 35 is one group, and their based on income is above 90,000, probably one group, above 100,000 another group, and things like that. So it clusters, it forms the different clusters of the user. So for example, in this particular case, probably what we can do is, let's say John John and George, we can put in this one group, right? Because they have a similar age and they have around similar income range. And we can put Ron and Archie in one group because they have similar income range, right? And similarly, we can also do the grouping between the based on the other factors. Now the problem that we are trying to solve is, and when the new user comes in like Josh, and we know about his age, gender and income, can we suggest that it can be approved or loan can be approved or not? So what the system will do is it will first try to find out which cluster the John is part of, like, right? So as I said earlier, the system will perform a different cluster. So maybe C1 has John and George. C2 has Ron and Archie, and C3 has, let's say, other users, Jane and Seth, right? So when the new user comes in, John, the system will try to find out whether it belongs to C1, C2, C3, right? And then, let's say, based on our age group, it looks like the user can belong to in the group of John and George because their income is similar. And historically, we find that all the majority of the users in this group have loaned their approved status. So we can say for Josh also, we can approve the loan, right? So this is how the user-based collaborative filtering works, where we crowdsource the information based on the user characteristics. Now, I wanted to show you a few more examples of recommendation system. Right. So let's see. Even you go to Netflix, right? So you will see lots of examples. So let's talk. So these are all form of recommendations, right? Where Netflix is trying to surface the different content based on the categories, and these are all some form of recommendations. So for example, the new releases. This is a content-based recommendation, and the recommendation was done based on when the movie was published, right? And it just started in the descending order of the date. Then another example of a content-based system is this trending now, where based on the popularity of the content, the recommendations have been given. Blockbuster movie, again here, the movie's recommendation have been given based, again it's an example of a content-based recommendation. Here, the movies are sorted based on their box office revenue, right? And again, here, the movies are based on the critical acclaimness of that movie. And again, this is based on the popularity on the Netflix. So, one example that I wanted to show you, which stood out to me, was... an example of a personalized recommendation. Like I like a lot of Indian movies, so that's why Netflix has also added more category like in Indian movies. So this is an example of a personalized recommendation that is based on where I'm from, based on my name. Probably they have discovered that I'm Indian and they're based recommending based on that. So this is an example of a collaborative filtering, like topics for Ravindra. So here, based on what I watched previously and based on what other users have rated the movies, it's going to give me the recommendations, right? So one thing that I wanted to mention is this item-based and user-based collaborative filtering suffer from something called a cold start problem, because in either case we either need to know how users have rated the items or how we can cluster the users. So we need to know a lot about the users and a lot about the items. So typically, let's say a new search engine comes, they don't know anything about users, or they don't know anything about how the items have been rated, right? So they cannot use this to begin with. So the way they go about is they go with this content-based recommendations, where just like the example of Netflix, where we saw even if the user is new or the complete Netflix website just they have started, we can start recommending based on the popularity or trending or purely based on the categories, right? So as the system accumulates more and more information about users, how they have rated movies, and their personal information, Netflix will start also recommending the collaborative filtering, like it's doing it over here. So topics for Ravindra is a example of a collaborative filtering. So that's all about collaborative filtering. That's all about, in general recommendation system, and collaborative recommendation is just part of it. So the bottom line to remember is recommendation is nothing but the way of offering suggestions, and don't get bogged down by these fancy terms like collaborative filtering. It is just a way of saying that we are offering recommendations based on the correlation between users, an item like products, movies, and how they correlate to each other based on the crowdsourcing information like ratings or the popularity and things like that. And personalized, also we saw an example of a personalized, like based on my own interest, Netflix is recommending me a lot more recommendations.